Hello and welcome to another tutorial in our class of assembly. In this chapter I will dedicate our time to study the concepts of shift right and shift left. As you can see, right now I'm displaying the numbers in the registers up here, yes, in binary form. And why do I do that? I mean, the app allows us to show it in a number of visual ways, okay, in the format. We can put it in binary, hexadecimary, unsigned decimal, and signed decimal, okay? Why do I do it on a binary format? The reason is that eventually, right now, the machines, the most basic number base, which is binary in this case, of base 2, that is being used by machines is binary. The reason why it's built by binary is because we shouldn't forget that 0 represents off and 1 represent on. And in binary transistors systems, it's the only way to create a representation or combined representation of complex elements. And what do I mean by that? We already know from class that to represent 256 combinations of numbers, yes, let's put Einstein, we can use eight bits, okay? 8 bits, which is in this case the perfect example here, okay? 8 bits, let's put it in binary. So there are 8 bits here. If I put everything to 1, yes, I should, sorry, I don't know why it's not, enter. Doesn't allow me. Okay, it's because 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Well, I guess I'm not able to change it manually. If I move to AL, the number 1111111. I think I have to put binary in the right side. And let's call it tutorial 2. Okay, so that's in my head. Great. Okay. If I compile and I execute, okay, great. Now I have the number, everything into 1, right? Representing that complete the word, which we call generally 8 bits together. As you know, a byte is called a word, okay? So the word is absolutely on in every single bit. And if we change it, the format to unsigned decimal, you will see that the number is 255. Thing is that with 8 bits, we can get to represent 255 different values, okay? From 0 to 255, which eventually is 256 different values. And all this, why do I explain all this? Very simple. The CPU in our case works with 8 different registers. Low and high, well, 4 registers with low side and high side of the register. In theory, if we combine AL and AH, yeah, we can represent it, we call it AX. Okay, in many places you will see AX, which is the complete combination of these two. So instead of representing 256 combination, if we add the bytes in this side, we will have a much larger the bits in this side will have a much larger representation of numbers. Okay, from that point on, if we consider, for example, the ASCII table, yes, which is a table that represents a letter for each number, we can say that we can represent 255 letters, or sorry, 256 different letters here, and that way we can start creating text and words. So eventually, yeah, we started from the most basic format representation the ability to create combinations, and from that on, create complex programs. Okay, great. So, what is shift left and shift right? Very simple. Shift left and shift right, yeah, are two operators that allow us to move the beat to the right or to the left. And now we're gonna see what it means, okay? So let's first execute this app. And okay, and it should have, great. Now we have the value 000 with 1, which is eventually the number 1. And if we change the format to unsigned decimal, it's 1, great. If I then tell shift left AL, and you have to tell him by 1 shift, 1 movement to move the number 1 here to the left, what will happen, yeah, is that the number 1 will move to the left. But what that really means, what it means, and that's very interesting, is that the number now changes to 2. Okay, great. If I tell him to move 2 positions, yes, let's compile, it will now move here and it will be represented with a number 4. So if you see the pattern, you will notice that we are multiplying it by 2 all the time. Okay, the idea here is that when you shift the number, when you shift the bits, all of them to the left, by the way, when you shift, you're shifting all of them to the left or all of them to the right. Yeah, when you shift them, all of them to the left, we're multiplying it by 2. Okay, a binary representation, as you know, it's 2, each position is powered by 2. 2 powered by 0, 2 powered by 1, 2 powered by 2, and we sum them. And we tend to sum it to get the final value, okay? If we shift it by 3, it should be now, the value should be 8. And so on. If we shift it by 4, the value should be 16. Okay, so we're multiplying by 2. And if you want to be, for example, sure that let's instead of moving a complete byte, let's move a number, okay, a real number. Let's put number 10. If we move 10 to the registry and we multiply and we shift it, okay, if we assign 10 here and we shift it 1 position, it should be multiplying it by 2, multiplying it by 2. And you can see if we do that, the value will be 20. Again, what really happened is that we first put the, I think we can put it at in 0 so we understand, yes. So if we, no, we cannot put 0. I just want to put the number 10 so we can see it. Well, we can do it, shift left AL 1. Okay, we can do it step by step. Okay, like we said. So first step, we put the value 10 inside the variable here. Okay, the register, and we're gonna shift it 1 position, all of it to the left. As you can see, everything moved, and that means that we multiply it by 2. Okay, so we have to understand, and it's very important, that multiplications in computers, in all computers, the multiplication process is really done by twos, okay, by binary multiplications. When you execute a multiplication in a much more complex program, what it tries to do is simplify it to powered by 2 and then try to multiply it or divide it, okay? Division is really shift right. When you shift it to the right instead of to the left, what will happen is that we divide it by 2. Okay, First, we put number 10 here, value of 10. Let's see how it looks unsigned. 10, and then we have to do the next line, divided by 2, which is really moving everything. Let's do it again. First, we put 10, and then we move it to the right, and what will happen, that we'll divide it by 2. So if you, as you can see, we don't have really to do all the jumping we did in the last example, yeah? We could have just shift to the right and shift to the left, but we shouldn't forget that in these cases, it only works if we want to shift, or we want to multiply by 2 or divide by 2. In the following part of the tutorial, in the next tutorial, I will explain a bit how the signed system works, so we know if the number is we can detect the number is in the last position here, or a number goes out is a signed or not signed number. Okay.